as I say, when I joined the library, and my main hobby is reading beside the boxing, and you start reading, philosophy, Aristotle, Plato, Socrates, I start reading politics, but I got another book a few weeks ago, The Spiritual Teachings of Marcus Aurelius. It's absolutely brilliant. But before that, when I was a kid about seven, I'd come across a lot of clever people. We had a coach, my father's pal, a fella called Dan Stewart, a Scotchman. He was a brilliant fighter, he was only small, but he could talk to you about boxing. And it was such a beautiful art, like of slipping punches, you know, of getting out of the way. And I used to listen to him. But he wasn't only teaching you about boxing, he'd be teaching you about life. And I'd come across people over there that were smashing people in Ireland. And after the war, when it was 1947, fellas used to come back from either England, after being in the British Army, or worked in the factories, or come back from America. And one fella, I can't remember, well, I didn't even know his name, but he used to say, look for the secret of life. Look for the secret of life. That is so important. What's important in life? And I've realized over the years, it's number one should be God. Number two is your health. Number three is your education. So when I started learning from the about education and how important it was, I got a lot of practical knowledge and experience. I'd worked on building sites, I'd worked in the steelworks. When I was here in 63, I went back to live. And the Irish that had been away in England and America, I could talk, no problem at all. The Irish that had been nowhere, I was arguing with them, and I was sticking up for the system over here and what was happening here. But I realized then the most important thing you can give anyone is your time, your knowledge, and your experience. Well, through trial and error, for making plenty of mistakes, I'd learned a lot. So I'd be saying to the kids in here, you know, most important thing is your education. Don't wag it from school. Go to school, learn. You've got education, it'll open doors all over the place, but you need practical experience and all. So I'd be teaching them hand, foot, eye coordination, voice coordination. And you say, what do you mean? Well, I'd get like this and I'd go, there. Boom. My hands and my feet as I'm moving are coordinating. Now, red and yellow and pink and green. My voice, my eyes, my hands and my voice are in coordination. So people used to think I was mad. What's this got to do with boxing? Well, boxing's all about time and distance, coordination, mobility, flexibility, agility, rhythm. But if you've got someone to sit down and explain it to you, because when I was at school, if I didn't know the answers, you used to say, you know, more or less you're tick, you're stupid. And I think everybody's good at something, but what you've got to do is spend the time with them. I don't rip you off, you don't rip me off. You don't tell me lies, I won't tell you lies. If I'm in here and I'm the teacher and I'm explaining to you what to do, I say to them, if you drink alcohol, if you drink, smoke, gamble, run around with more than one woman, or do drugs, or tell lies, all you're going to do is get your life into a mess. If you drink, you know what I mean, get with your mates, you don't need drink. You don't need to gamble. If you gamble and lose your money, then you can't concentrate. If the government spend 5 million advertising not to drink, and the drink industry spends 100 million, the 100 million is going to win. It's only common sense. It's all, everything's about economics.